Hi butterflies, I've had the idea of making a video on how I got my buttfish teach. So since it was recently his birthday, now seemed like the perfect time. To tell this story, we're gonna start long before I got teach, a little after Finding Nemo came out. After seeing the movie, I loved the fish so much my parents got me a betta fish. They didn't have the heart to tell me when the fish died, so instead went out and got a new one that looked just like it, so I wouldn't find out. They did this for years, but eventually decided they figured I was old enough, because I was no longer four, and didn't want to do it anymore, and told me about the fish. I had thought it was the same fish for years, since whenever it looked different, they told me that betta fish change colors as they got older. My mom told me what actually happened, and how her and my dad's secret name for the fish was body double. Now keep this in mind, because it comes in later in the story. So about a year ago, I decided I wanted a fish to keep me company at college. This is because the only pets allowed in the dorm are fish with a max tank size of 5 gallons. I had stayed at the college for a month over summer for a program. At some point there, me and my friends went to the PetSmart nearby to look at the animals. We went to the fish aisle. There was this cute little goldfish with funny eyebrows that I absolutely adored and wanted so bad. But my mom had me wait since I was leaving to go back home in a week, and I couldn't get the proper stuff to take care of him, so he would have to live in a cup for a week, and that's not very nice. So I waited. When I got back home, my mom took me to the PetSmart near our house, and we found another one of the goldfish with the funny eyebrows. I saw on the label it suggested a minimum of 25 gallons for the tank size. I asked the employee at PetSmart about it, and they told me how the goldfish wouldn't be able to live happily in anything smaller. I told them how the max tank size I was allowed was 5 gallons. The employee then suggested a betta fish since they can live in smaller tanks. Now remember how I told you about the fish from when I was younger? Well, I always remember them being very unhappy and unfriendly. They'd never come up to you in the tank and just sat at the bottom. Having remembered this, I was determined not to get a betta fish. I didn't just want a fish to have a fish, I wanted one that would be my friend. So I started looking at the other fish and their tank sizes to see if there was one I liked that could live in a smaller tank. After looking around for a while, we couldn't stay any longer because my mom had to pick up my siblings from school. So on the way out, I caved and grabbed a betta pamphlet to learn more about them. I wanted to know if they were all like the fish I remember, or my mom just sucked at picking fish. After watching a few YouTube videos and reading a couple articles about bettas, we found out my mom, as hard as she tried, didn't take care of the bettas very well. She had done what PetSmart told her, but it wasn't correct what they told her. So the reason I remember the bettas being so grumpy and mean was because they didn't have a good tank. With this newfound information, I went into PetSmart with a plan. I decided if I got a baby betta, it would love me because I would be its mom. So I had my mom help me find all the tiniest bettas, and we lined up all their cups on the counter. And that's how I found him. With all the cups lined up, one little fish sat there looking at me. And now I have the best little bud who always comes to say hi to me and will sit at the bottom of the tank or on his leaf while I do homework and draw. That's the story of Finding Teach. If you'd like to keep up to date on me and this little dude's shenanigans, I post videos and pictures of him for Teach Tuesday on my Instagram story and Twitter. Also, I'd like to say, if you ever think about getting your own betta, or any fish or pet for that matter, make sure you do a lot of research beforehand. I've tried looking up as much as I can on my own little dude, but there's still new things I'm learning about him, or learning I've been doing wrong. He actually got sick recently, so I started looking into it and found out what I thought was the proper way to clean his tank isn't. I recommend finding a professional fish store near you if you can. Like I said in the story, I went to PetSmart to get teach, but now knowing a lot more about bettas, I would definitely recommend going to a fish store. They take way better care of their fish and know what they're talking about. I went to the one by my house to get stuff to help teach, so hopefully he'll be doing better soon. That's all I got for you guys. I'll see you later. Bye!